family's photos used against them. A Crittenden woman says someone used her kid's picture to make money. Good evening once again. The shocking discovery has this family looking for answers.
It started with someone stealing the child's pictures from Instagram. Now, only on 9 on Your Side, Julie O'Neill has their story and what to do if this happens to you.
It's the face of an angel and apparently the perfect one for a scam. 2-year-old Lyric, AKA Adeline Page.
Here's some more pictures of Adeline Page, clearly my child. These were stolen directly from my Instagram page.
Kayla McLean says a couple from Louisiana saw a post she'd placed of her daughter on Instagram's recent page and realized it was her daughter's picture some couple was using to get money from them. They contacted Kayla through Instagram,
saying that that couple that was reaching out to them had custody of her, that she had a seizure condition, which she does have a seizure condition, which I mean, they've been going through my Instagram, getting all of my information. That they needed money. When the couple refused to give them the money, they just kept sending pictures for a couple weeks and then was like, well, we're junkies and we need someone to take her in. Is there any way you can take care of her for us for a while we get clean? Like, essentially, like, will you meet us and take our kid?
McLean was beside herself.
We reached out to Instagram, we reached out to the police, we reached out to the FBI, and nobody says that they can do anything.
If a third party comes and takes your picture, they are potentially liable.
But attorney Jack Weiner says since the actual solicitations came through texting apps, Kick and Pinger, McLean should first contact them to flag the accounts.
I mean, she is my child, and people are saying that she's theirs and offering to give her away to them. And I mean, what parent wouldn't be livid?
Attorney Jack Weiner tells me he does believe there's a case for wire fraud here, some sort of scam going on. One place you can go to report it is stopfraud.gov. It lists the different kinds of fraud so you can navigate through and make a report via email to the federal government. I've also reached out to the U.S. Prosecutor's Office, and as we get more on this case, we'll keep you posted. Julie O'Neill, 9 on Your Side.